So all those who've just logged in, a very warm and a cordial welcome. But before we start off, a couple of things that you need to watch out as we start, okay? A few disclaimers, if I may have to say. Challenging the challenges that the time is throwing at us, HPE CSC Bangalore is ensuring that the show must go on, right? A lot of people from HPE CSC Bangalore have put in their heart and mind into making this event possible. The least you can do is to support them by doing the following five things. Please listen carefully. First up, I need the cameras to be on all the time. You need to put your cameras on all the time because I'm going to make this an extremely interactive session. So your facial expressions are very, very important to me. All right. No matter how you look right now, no matter where you are, no matter how your background looks, don't worry about that. We just need your facial reactions. Okay. So please put your cameras on. I want everyone's cameras to be on right away. Secondly, make sure you punch in your name. Make sure you punch in your name the way you would want me to call you. All right, because I'm going to be making it interactive. So I'm going to be using your name. So please do not put in any code or any number or any initials like that. Just put in your complete name or just put in your first name at least. All right. So go to your name, right click that and you can rename yourself. So just change your name quickly if you have put in something else apart from your name. And thirdly, I request you to please keep your mic on mute to ensure a smooth flow of this event. Please don't mind. Whenever I'm speaking to you one-on-one, you can unmute yourself. You just need to keep your finger on the unmute button and unmute yourself every time I'm talking to you. All right. And ensure, number four, ensure no one's encroaching your frame or clearing noise in the background. Basically, lock your room for the next couple of minutes. Give you 100%. We need that because this is something we planned for you. And lastly, have patience. We're dealing with technology here. I'm sure you guys know the connectivity. I'm sure you guys know how the networks work. There could be glitches or lags, but just hang in there. All right. So I need your patience. So quickly, going through all your 5 points, your camera's on all the time. Make sure that you have a name punched in the way you want me to call you. Thirdly, keep yourselves on mute whenever you need to talk. I will let you unmute yourself. Please unmute yourself then. And then make sure no one's encroaching your frame. And lastly, have some patience if something goes wrong in terms of a lag or a glitch, all right? So if you're ready, let's go then. Everyone's ready? here we go. All right. A very warm and a cordial welcome to one and all present right here. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the beautiful enclaves of your very own homes and offices that you're joining us from. And yes, of course, welcome to HPE CSC Bangalore. There is no place like working from home. Well, I would say welcome to a new normal, or rather the new world order. You've been doing a great job working for HPE CSC Bangalore, supporting your team, your colleagues amidst all the COVID stress with work from home, right? It's time now to unwind and celebrate that by having some fun from home, because HPE CSC Bangalore truly believes that there is no place like working from home. Yes, so I welcome you once again to this unique, new age, one of its kind virtual fun event that kicks off today. It promises to give you a week full of fun, entertainment, performances, prizes, surprises, gigs and gags. So just get ready for that. A quick little introduction about myself. I don't like doing it this way, but my mom insists that I have to. I'm a mama's boy, so I'm just going to do it that way. My name is MJ Rakesh, the mic jockey. Okay, I've been a radio jockey on a radio station called 94.3 Radio 1 for about a decade. I used to host the morning show with MJ Prithvi. I'm sure you guys would heard of it. And then right now I work for another radio station called Super Hits 93.5 Red FM. Yes, and for those of you who've been on the radio for the longest time and you would have heard radio, you would know this character, Professor Ulfat Sultan. That's what I used to script and voice. It's been on the radio for about 10 years. It's called Seekho Mere Saath, English Ki Do Baat. That was me, yes. And if not there, you would have found me on any of the IPL stages or Pro Kabaddi stages across the country, because I'm the official MC for ICC, BCCI, Star Sports and Sony Max. I travel across the country, host the IPLs and Pro Kabaddis at the stadium live. And if nothing at all, if you are someone who's localized and tuned into the regional television, you would have found me in last year's Big Boss Canada. I was there for 95 days. All thanks for voting and keeping me there. So this is me, MJ Rakesh, your mic jockey. My mom insisted that I give out all these points. That's why I'm doing it. Otherwise, I don't like boasting about myself. So let's get started. Your mic jockey is right here. But before I start, I need to see a quick response from everybody. All right. But before the response, I see a lot of people who have still not turned on their cameras. Ram Mahapatra, Venkat Athriya, Komala Chetan, Chaitra Prakash, you need to get your cameras on, all right? Tabitha, Shushmita, Karthik, Ravi Ranjan, I want everyone's cameras to be on. Please, quickly, I'm going to give you 5 seconds to do that. Priya Kulkarni, Joshua, Nutan, Rajiv Ranjan, what is it with you guys? Yeah, come on, get your cameras on. Shreya Shukla, I want everybody's to be camera on, okay? Upasana, Rajesh Gopala, Babu NR, Syed, don't make me call out your names individually, guys, please. Please, Alisha Sharma, why is your camera off? Please, you can have your lunch later. Ritik G, switch on kijiye apna camera, please. Quick, everybody. I want everyone's cameras to be on, okay? Everyone's cameras to be on. Don't worry about what's in the background. Don't worry about how you look. Aruna DR, I don't want to see that emoticon which you put up on your screen. Please, Kirti Sheila, that's a lovely profile picture you've put up. I would love to see it more, but not now. Get your camera on. Sushichmita Rath. See, your name itself is so difficult for me to pronounce. I have to see your face. Come on, guys. Quickly, 5 seconds. I'm going to give you 5 more seconds. Rajiv Ranjan. Please, Vineet Bharadwaj. I need all your cameras on, okay? And please stay that way. Whoever is switching off their cameras, I'm going to stop the show and particularly come at you guys, okay? You don't want me doing that, right? So make sure your cameras are on throughout. So let me get it started. Okay, after a wonderful start that we've had this morning with the stand-up comedian Kritar Srinivasan and a power speaker that we had, which was Afif Ahmed, we thought we'd spend the afternoon unearthing some of our in-house talent and bringing them onto the limelight, right? The stage is set, the audience you can see right here is eager, and we have an array of talent waiting to roll out from dance, singing, poetry, art, and whatnot. I'm going to be starting this off right now, and and each of the performers here are going to be gratified with an exclusive gift that is going to reach you. All right. So you can look forward to that as well. So first up, ladies and gentlemen, even before I start off, I need to hear a quick response from everyone. Can you just quickly go to your chat and in the drop down, choose everyone as the option and say whatever you want to say right now. Whatever you want to say, however you're feeling, whatever you want to say to your colleague, whatever you want to say to your boss, whatever you want to say to the whole of HVECSE Bangalore, just quickly say that. I want to see the responses. At least we know that we are all alive and we are interacting on a virtual medium. Come on, quick. I want to see your chats. Come on. Keep sending in. Yes, nice. Crazy Monday. Good to see familiar faces. Nice. Beautiful weather. You can't, I must tell you, right next to me, if you can see this grilled window, it's actually a window and I can hear the sound of the rain. And that's how beautiful it is sounding to me right now. Alisha Arora says, good luck, Kavya. She says, wonderful day with awesome rain. All the best, guys. Rock it. Come on, please send it. I want everyone to at least send one message. Okay? This is like a shagun. You know, right? When you start something good, you need to put in like that 1 rupee or 101 rupee or 10-11 rupee, you put it, right? So this is like your shagun chat. Quickly, come on, guys. I want to see everyone responding. Hi, everyone. It's pouring here, waiting to have fun. That's Tabitha. Syed Shoba says, good afternoon. Abhijit is just kind of yawning on the camera. Nice. Keep the energy up. Vineet Bharadwaj has given the shortest message of the day. He just says, hi. It's okay. We'll take whatever comes our way. We had a good start in the morning. Take it to the next level, folks. That's what Ishwara says. Of course, Ishwara, Parmeshwara, we are going to reach you. We're going to reach your level. All right. Come on, guys. Quick. I still see Kavyashri not switching on a camera. Karthik Jagannath, Venkat Athriya, Komal Chetan. What? Why are you guys so stubborn? Gopal Jha, Ramakrishna, Pradeep Prabha, please switch on your cameras, guys. Niharika Mittal, Babu NR. It's very unfair when you come onto a virtual platform to consume something and you don't want to give, right? It's very unfair when you want to take something, you want to see something, you want to hear something, but you don't want to give it from your side. It's really unfair for the performers, right? So please, for the last time, I'm going to say, get your cameras on, all right? Cool then. Let's get started.
Hi, Rakesh. Alisha on the side.
Yes, Alisha.
Actually, I've turned on my camera, but I don't know why it's still showing black. Could you just give me another 2 minutes? I'll just sort it out.
Okay, maybe you should just probably open your eyes. I think it's just shut. And
No, I can see that I have turned on the camera and it is not covered also.
I'm just kidding. Maybe sometimes what happens is the Zoom has this technicality where you have to disconnect and re-log in. And maybe
you can. I'll do that. Yeah.
All right, just do that. All right. Hi, Rakesh. How much do you miss airlines? Venkat Athriya. Oh my God. This is someone who knows where I hang out usually. Yes, Airlines Hotel is one of my favorite hangouts. Thank you, Venkat. I'm going to connect with you shortly. Cool then. I'm going to start off with our first performance, ladies and gentlemen. Here goes. Like I said, we decided we'll use this afternoon to kind of unearth a little bit of talent that we have in-house. Okay, we had a lot of talented people who came in the morning and showed their talent. One was, of course, the stand-up comedian. And secondly, we had a powerful speaker, Afif Ahmed. Right now, we have our very own colleagues, friends, who are going to be up here on the screens. entertaining you. They've got some special talent. They worked really hard to be here on this performance. Make sure your adulation, your applause, your cheers for them do not stop. Applause can be virtually with you guys unmuting yourself for 5 seconds, putting your hands together. And whenever the performances are happening, please do keep sending in your chats. Whatever you feel about the performance, whatever you want to tell them, appreciate in terms of your words, all right? So here goes. First up, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a live performance right now, which is going to be performed by Alisha Sharma. I think she's just gone a little offline. We're going to wait for her to come back. But before that, let's quickly go on with the second performance that we have lined up, which is going to be an art, which she calls it as do-it-yourself art. And this is going to be a recorded video that's put together by Harkaval Kaur. A round of, please unmute yourselves. Unmute yourselves for 5 seconds and give her a round of applause, everyone. Come on, unmute, unmute. Fantastic. I think we have Alisha Sharma back. Do we have you? Alisha? Okay. I don't think we have Alisha yet. We'll go ahead with Harkaval Kaur as our first performer. Let's go. I'm going to let my console take over and flash the video for you. Here it is, a recorded performance by Harkaval Kaur. Over to my console.
Hello everyone, I am Harkaval from CACB RPS team. I hope you all are doing very well and I hope you all are safe. In this whole pandemic situation, we all have realized how important it is to be self-sufficient. And also, just like our Prime Minister Modi ji says, Atmanirbhar Bano. So that is what we are going to do today. And today I'll show you some really quick DIY hacks that you can do sitting at home. They are super easy and they'll help you save a lot of money too. So first in the queue is a mobile cover DIY. Yes, we'll be designing a mobile cover. So let's get started. So in this first DIY, all you need is a mobile cover, some colors, and your creativity. Here I am using a transparent one, but you can use any mobile cover. I am using transparent because for this DIY, I feel this is the most versatile one because you can actually play around with colors and you don't have any limitations when you have a transparent mobile cover. So just cut out the shape and let's start. Can actually have a new mobile cover every month or every week, every day also. So quickly moving on to the next DIY, we all know how important it is to stay positive and motivated during these times. So what's better than having a poster with a motivational or positive quote on it? Yes, so next DIY is that only. We'll be designing a poster and let's get started. For this DIY, you actually need one sheet, some colors, a motivational quote, and once again, your creativity. Here, I am using watercolors. You can use any colors. I just feel that watercolors are easy to use, so that's why I'm using watercolors.
DIY. Frankly, this one is my favorite and I'm very sure that you all will like it too. So without any further blabbering, let's get started.
For this DIY, you need paper plates and once again some colors and your creativity, and you can very, very easily create these masterpieces at home.
How beautiful this has turned out to be. I hope you all like the video too, and all these DIYs are super easy, so I'm expecting that a lot of you will try these DIYs super soon. For more such videos, you can actually go and check out my YouTube channel, that is She the Happy Camper. I post fun DIY rap, rant, comedy videos every week, so do check out my channel and show your support there also. With that, let's end this video. Thank you so much for watching this video and stay home, stay safe. Bye bye.
Wow, what energy! Wow, this is so colorful. Okay, first up, I want everyone to unmute your mics. Quickly unmute your mics and give her a round of applause, guys, with your hands in front of the camera, please. Come on. Lovely. Har Kaval Kaur, that is for you. I see some interesting messages that have come in here. Alicia Arora says, plates can be used for more than just for eating. Upasana Malhotra, very beautifully appreciates, saying that very creative and the way it was recorded is amazing. Simply amazing. We'll try them at home is what Alicia says. Gopalja says, awesome. Wow. We've been receiving amazing response. You've inspired me to try make a poster to this, says Tabita. Sridhar says, very creative and beautiful at work. Inspiring. I want to ask you one thing, Har Kaval Kaur. I'm sure you're used to these kind of compliments that come at you the moment you do something and you present it out, right? I just want to know, your lockdown seems to be quite interesting and entertaining and colorful. Yeah? If I may have to say.
Yeah, right. You're very much right. Actually, the idea behind such videos, in fact, on YouTube, I try to post DIY videos regularly because in this lockdown time, we all have time for the things we never had time for.
Okay.
So we can actually give time to our passions, our hobbies, and this is my passion. So I thought let's create and let's make the world colorful.
You know what, Har Kaval, you give a completely different meaning to the world, to the word DIY, to the phrase DIY. You say do it yourself kind of art, which is so beautiful and all that, right? In my place at home, DIY is used in a very different way. Every time I go to the kitchen, I ask mom for something like DIY, do it yourself. A couple of my friends, when I tell them, can you help me out with this DIY, do it yourself. So thank you so much, Har Kaval. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wonderful,
thank
you. Here to start it off for us. Yeah, round of applause for her once again on the virtual, please. on the virtual screen, everyone. Come on, let's go. Thank you so much. Okay, now is when I'm going to move into my next performer, who is ideally supposed to be our first performer. That is Alisha Sharma, with a very beautiful piece of poetry that she's written, and she's going to take it live. Alisha, if you're here, over to you. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, with your round of applause, unmute your mics. This is the only job you have to do, okay? Unmute your mic, applaud, mute your mic back, go back to your chat and send whatever you want to send. Can we have a round of applause for Alisha Sharma, please? Come on, everyone.
Thank you so much. A very good afternoon to everyone. And I hope all the people are doing safe and good. And my good wishes to all of you. Stay safe and stay healthy. And today I've come to share a piece of poetry with all of you, which I've written. And this is very much related to the period that we are going through. And I have tried that I mentioned all the people who have played a very important role in our lives in this time. And that's it. I think I should not delay it further and go ahead and recite it in front of you. I hope you all will like it. Okay, so all of you can hear me?
Yes, we can. Go ahead.
All right. So a few days ago, I woke up early. Things are different, they say. There are less people out there, but I wonder, why are they carrying an outfit so rare? I read about them in the newspaper. They say they are lifesaver. Every single day, they wake up early. Name any part of the world, be it Washington, D.C. or Mumbai Worli. Their kids are asleep. When they leave homes, they are braver than the Emperor of Rome. A big salute to them from the masses. Without them, we will be like withered flowers in the vases. They are our doctors, they are nurses, and they are the hospital staff. Their contribution to the world is just like an exponential graph. Our offices on the duty. 24/7 they are there. Without any lapse, they do it because they care. A big salute to the armed forces and the police forces. They are with us for the larger causes. And to you and to me, and to you and to me, thousands of civilians alike who are standing tall in this fight. We know that this virus will one day be knocked down and one day we all will gather normally around. Not the gloomy days will be wasted, trust me. Not the gloomy days will be wasted. Those days have the power to bring the pause between the action and the response. Those days have the power to bring the pause between the action and response. All the happy days also, all the happy days also will be invested to make us better than who we are, to make us better than who we are in this battle of 2020. You know what? In this battle of 2020, our togetherness will be our superpower. Thank you so much.
Wow. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much, Alisha Sharma. Can everyone please unmute and give her a big round of applause, guys? Come on. Everyone, please unmute
Thank
your
you so
mic
much.
And do this for her. Lovely. Yes. Absolutely. Your poetry is only as beautiful as you. I mean,
thank you so much.
I do understand that, yes, we're all going through tough times. And it naturally is for someone who is a writer can write something as beautiful as this. You've been writing for a long time?
So this journey began when I was in, I think, first year of college. And I don't know when it came. Like, I wrote a poem. And after that, there were so many moments when I just wanted to spill out whatever there was in my mind. And it's like sometimes you get a flood of words and you just write it down and then you feel very much relieved. So that is the case with me. So it's been long time and I'm involved in the poetry. I am associated with Poets of Bangalore, and also I'm associated with my own cause, which is Inspire Angels. So yeah, that's about it.
You know what, Alisha, from what I've heard about people who write or people who are like poets, they're either in love or they are heartbroken. Has anything been the case with you?
Yeah, I would say I'm just like any other human being. So yes, I have both been in love and been heartbroken.
Oh, all right, lovely then.
When I say heartbroken, it doesn't only about the romantic love or the other way. So
yes,
it's like the human experience, you know, it teaches us a lot of things. And that is how I feel that when I, you know, write down something, it makes me feel relaxed. And not only that, I really like a lot of Urdu poetry and English poetry, because it's like, for me, I'm not an avid reader. So when I read very small poetry and small, you know, couple of lines, it feels like gagar mein sagar bharne wali baat.
Wow.
So that is how it
very,
is.
Very, very smartly and beautifully, you're not letting out your personal life out to us. It's okay. We're not going to dig in further. You can be in love or you're probably heartbroken single. We're going to let that be. We're going to let all the people here keep guessing what is Alisha's status right now in terms of relationship, at least. All right. Thank you so much, Alisha. I'm going to let you go. But stay on the call with us because I have more talent coming its way. And right after this, I'm going to start off a quick little contest, which is going to be a chat-based, and I want everyone to respond to that. Here comes another super talent we have in the house. Like, I'm sure a lot of guys, okay, a lot of friends, at least that I know of, have been complaining that this entire lockdown period, they've turned into housemates, they've turned into cooks at home, they've been doing all the job that probably a maid or probably their wives were doing. That's okay. But we have one such man who's taken to cooking very seriously and has actually made it like his talent. And that is Jonathan Jaisingh, who's actually going to show us what he's cooked and what he wants to cook with you guys. Here goes, all eyes on the screen because it's a recorded performance by him. Unmute your mics and please give him a round of applause. Jonathan Jaisingh on the screen, please. Come on, everyone. Over to my console. Very, very interesting. Can you please unmute yourselves and give him a round of applause, guys? That is Jonathan Jaisingh. Unfortunately, we couldn't see him in the video, but let's see him here. Jonathan, are you here? Please come onto the screen. Jonathan, unmute yourself and speak to us. Are you here? Jonathan?
Yeah, I'm here, Rakesh. Can you hear me? Can you hear me, everyone?
Yes, yes, yes. You know, I do not know about how your kitchen looks or probably how your place is. But suddenly with that video and the way you were cooking, you made it appear like some five star. Is it so? Is your home like a five-star kitchen or something? It did
look
like...
it's actually a modular kitchen. We have it at home. Okay. But the video what I shared was actually a demo video. Mm-hmm. So because of my training timings over the last week, I couldn't get time to share the full video, in fact, and I kept it ready. But unfortunately, I couldn't share the full video, which had all the titles. But I hope you all liked this short video. Probably in the next session, I can share the full video, in fact. Yeah.
We will like it only if you please switch on your camera, because that's a rule in this session. You need to get your camera on. Please get your camera on. We would like to see you. We didn't even see you in the video. At least let us see you here. Why are you being so secretive about your identity? Jonathan, I can still see like a dark black screen. Why is that?
Can you hear me?
There you are. You just emerged like an Iron Man right in the front. Okay, Jonathan, tell me something. Are you like the Tarla Dalal or the Sanjeev Kapoor or the Ranveer Brar? Who do you get inspired mostly by? Or don't tell me.
I myself is the best cook I can think of. So I don't compare with anyone. I don't follow anyone. I don't watch any cookery shows or the food shows. So I cook. I try to create dishes of my own interest and different combinations I try. And then, my team can give a witness on behalf of me. They would have liked my taste or the way I cook.
Okay, so, if your team members are here, I want you to quickly go to the chat and respond to this. If you guys are here and tell me what you like of Jonathan, what he cooks. But quickly, who cooks mostly at home, Jonathan?
Home, I cook for all the non-veg dishes. All the non-vegetarian I cook mostly. Okay. Yeah.
And who cooks the rest of it?
My wife.
Your wife. So your wife is veg and you're non-veg.
Nothing like that. We both eat anything.
I was not even referring to food, by the way.
Yeah.
Salt alternative to oil, especially this time with the lack of workout. I didn't know actually you could cook stuff in salt. I always thought these are things that have to be cooked in. And Ada Khan says, what was that white sand thing?
It's a salt, actually. Yeah.
It is salt, Ada. It's not white sand. Okay, exceptional, Jonathan. That's what Abhijit says. And Shrija says, awesome. Thank you so much, Jonathan. You've been fantastic. And keep your cooking skills on. And try and organize potlucks in the office once you are back so that you get a little more food. And we know that you'll be getting more food than any of us will, right? Because
you'll be thank you. Yeah, sure.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Everyone, round of applause for Jonathan, please. Come on. Quick. Okay, so here goes. I'm going to make a quick little announcement once again, because I'm going to slip into one little contest that I've planned for you. I want everyone's camera to be on right now. Okay? I want Priya Kulkarni, Nutan, Karthik, Babu, Pradeep, Jonathan. I want everyone's cameras to be on, guys. I cannot insist more. Please understand, this is a session we planned for you. And this is a session where we need your physical presence in terms of your face being visible, because a lot's got to do with the facial reactions, right? You come here to consume something, you also need to give us something. So Joshua, Sindhu, Sudha, Prashant, I cannot have you guys just put your cameras off and sit back and do whatever you're doing. Please get your cameras on. Ashwini, Kavyashri, Reshma, Pradeep, Sindhu, Trupti, Archana Kumar, please don't let me come to you one-on-one and tell you these things. Keep your cameras on throughout. I want to see your facial expressions throughout. Okay, that's the only way we can feel that we are live and interacting. Otherwise, it's as good as doing it on the phone, right? It's as good as doing it on chat. Okay, so quickly here, I'm going to now, this is something that I asked a couple of our people in the morning as well. I'm going to ask you guys, because I want to know what's your quotient on this one. You know, each of us at some point in time in our life have been hit with something weird by someone, right? I want you to think back and tell me, what is that weird thing you've been hit with? I'm sure most of us have been hit with the balen. Most of us have been hit with a shoe. Actually, in my case, my mom actually threw an entire milk packet at me and it just burst open on my entire face and I felt like I was having a Mahabhishekam. Okay, so I want this audience here, anybody and everybody, quickly go to your chat and respond to everyone and tell me, what is that one thing weird that you have been hit with? And I want you to remember that incident, because we're going to share that now. Quickly go to your chat and I want you guys to switch on your camera. Jonathan, please come back. You were just here on with us. Suddenly you disappeared. Priya Kulkarni, go to your chat and tell me one thing weird that all of us have been hit by, okay, by someone. Okay, someone says a TV remote. Yeah, I can imagine that, Rajesh Nekanti. I think that's probably because you were fighting with your wife over the TV channel that you wanted to watch. Rajiv Ranjan says that he was hit with dirty water. How do you hit someone with dirty water? But why would someone first carry dirty water? Rajiv Ranjan, please unmute and talk to me. I want to talk to you right now. Rajiv Ranjan, you've been hit with dirty water?
Yeah.
How is that? Please tell me.
From the top in the apartment.
What? Come again. Give me a little more details as to who would carry dirty water?
From the top balcony.
Oh, from the top in the balcony. Someone poured dirty water onto you.
Yeah.
Did you mess with them or something?
No. It may happen to me also sometime.
Okay. Someone says, Ravi Ranjan says, he's been hit with a soap in school hostel. Okay. And this is a weird one. Kavya, she says that she's been hit with a thyroid tablet bottle. My God, I remember that. My mom is a thyroid patient and she uses this thyroid bottle. These are really small ones, but they're very, very hard. You know, they're very hard. I want to go to Kavya Shri. Please unmute and talk to me, Kavya Shri. Thyroid tablet bottle. How, when, where, what? It looks like a very disturbing scene to me.
It was. It was hit by my mom, of course.
Why was that?
I was forcing her to take the tablet and she was, I had taken her to hospital and doctor told she has to take the tablet. I'm like, you have to take this tablet. She's like, no, I don't want to. And she was a little cranky and she took the tablet and she hit it on me. It was like the Abhishekam of tablet with the bottle to me.
My God. But you should just tell her by throwing the tablet at me, it's not going to be considered consumption. It just is going to hurt you even more. Okay, I have one more that I'm going to take after which we move on with our performances. There's someone who says, Chaitra Prakash, she says she's been hit with a steel tiffin box. Chaitra Prakash, can you please come onto the camera? I don't want you to give me an explanation, but I want to see where the dent on your face is. Chaitra Prakash, where are you? Oh, there you are. You have a dent right there? Oh my God, look at this, ladies and gentlemen. We have an act of domestic violence right here with us. Tell me, why, how did this happen, Chaitra? Unmute and talk to us. Chaitra, unmute and talk to us.
It was a fight between me and my brother during school days. So I hit him here and he hit me here.
Oh my God. Okay, I'm going to take the last one because this is a really funny one. What is it, that weird thing that you've been hit with or hit by at some point in time in your life? Tabitha says she's been whacked on the face by a cow's tail. Tabitha, can you please come on and tell us what was this? That's you not being whacked. You just went and stood at the wrong place. You shouldn't be standing. Yes, please talk to us.
I was peacefully sitting in an auto. I was nowhere near the cow. And the auto stopped at a signal and the cow was passing by, and just when it was passing our auto is when it just swapped its tail and I got whacked on the face. And after that it was green, and before we could all go, all the others on either side saw it and everyone burst out laughing, and people even forgot that there was a green light and they had to move.
Oh my God. I can imagine. So that green mark that came onto you, was that cow dung or was it the effect of the impact?
No, luckily, I don't think it had done its work as yet. So it seemed like a clean tail anyway. There was nothing on my face.
You know
but
what?
It still scares me. I don't go near cows anymore.
You know what? Our heartfelt sympathies with you, our heartfelt condolences to you for having been through what you've been through. Okay, hope this never happens to you again or to anybody else at all. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to now quickly move into the performances again. Thank you so much. You guys have been lovely with your responses. Those of you who haven't responded, I'm going to give you this little time while the performances are on for you to think and respond, because I'm going to come back after this and we're going to interact a little more. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, let me move into my next performance. And this is going to be a dance performance. Okay. This is going to be a dance performance and not a recorded one. It's going to be a live dance performance. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's get ready for Shukla G, who's going to be coming onto the screen with a round of applause. Please unmute your mics and give Shreya Shukla a big, big round of applause, guys. Come on.
Thank you. Thank you so much, everyone. I hope you can hear me.
Yes, we can, Shreya. Please go ahead. And guys, whenever I tell you to please unmute your mics and give an applause, do that. It's just a little work that will take. Your finger needs to move. You're only going to burn 3 calories. Only 3 calories you'll burn by moving your finger, unmuting the mic and clapping for her. I'm going to ask everyone to do it again. Unmute yourself and clap for Shreya Shukla, please. Come on.
Thank you so much.
Over to you, Shreya. Take it on.
Thank you so much. So today I'll be performing a dance live, and this is the best I'm taking because of the technical glitches and everything. But the theme of my dance would be diversity. So as we know, the power of diversity and how much HPA believes in that. So that is what I'll be trying to showcase today. So it is basically amalgamation of 4 different songs of 4 different languages. And I have somewhat tried to do the native dance forms of the different languages. So I hope that you'll like it. Just a quick sound check. I hope it's audible.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much. Can everybody please do this again? Unmute your mics and give it a big round of applause, please. Come on. Lovely. Absolutely. Shukla ji, ye kahan se sikha apne? Are you like trained dancer or you just dance for fun? Yeah, actually I dance for fun. Mm-hmm. And since childhood, I was having a lot of interest. I'm sorry. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So,
okay. Catch
I've been into a few workshops. Of uh-huh. Shamak Davar uh-huh. and Birju Maharaj.
Wow.
So got something from there.
Wow.
And rest, just looking at the YouTube and choreographing myself. So this is how it's going.
Birju Maharaj and all that. Wow. Kaan pakadte jab baat karte Birju Maharaj saath ke baare mein. But fantastic. Lovely. Keep it up. We love your energy. And this is what we want. Looks like, you. Which floor of the house do you live in? First, second, third floor, what?
It's 9th floor.
You're on the 7th floor.
9th.
9th floor. Did your neighbors complain about you tapping your feet way too much on the floor?
No, actually, they come in and they join me here. So wow. Everybody is fond of dance too. Yeah.
Lovely. Wish I was your neighbor. Thank you so much, Shreya. Lovely. Lovely having you. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.
All right, guys, moving on quickly. Like I said, this is just the season of a lot of people reflecting on thoughts about themselves, about the world around. That's what actually it has done to all of us, right? This entire pandemic has given us that little pause button to sit back and think what we really think about life, what we really think about world, what we really think about the way we treat everything around us. So there's someone else, again, just like Alisha Sharma, who's taken to poetry, who's penned down his thoughts onto the paper, and he wants to share it with us. Ladies and gentlemen, giving us a live poetry recitation, I'm going to welcome onto the screen Vinit Bharadwaj. Unmute your mic for 5 seconds and give him a round of applause as we start. Come on, everyone. Come on. Kavita, Rajesh, everyone, please unmute your mics. Unmute your mics and give him a round of applause. Over to Vinit Bharadwaj.
Thanks, Rakesh. I hope I'm loud and clear.
Very clear. Please, sir, go ahead.
Thanks. So this point onwards, probably I'll talk in Hindi. So that's my language medium. And so, dosto, मैं अभी अभी एक छोटे से विचार बुन रहा था, तो एक बहुत पुरानी कहावत मेरे दिमाग में पड़ी कि जहां ना पहुंचे रवि वहां पहुंचे कवि। जैसा कि हम आज देख पा रहे हैं, चारों ओर बादल छाए हुए हैं, मानसून का मौसम है। आप लोगों के घर में भी डेफिनेटली रवि साहब नहीं पहुंचे होंगे। When I said रवि, रवि means सूरज, हमारे दिवाकर, प्रभाकर, दिनकर, जिनको कि हम नॉर्मल लैंग्वेज में सन भी कहते हैं। तो वो उदय नहीं हुए हैं, आज बादलों की वजह से पीछे छुपे हुए बैठे हैं। वो नहीं पहुंचे आपके घर, लेकिन मैं कवि आपके घर में साइंस के माध्यम से, विज्ञान के माध्यम से आपके घर में आज पहुंच चुका हूँ लाइव। तो आपके घरों में लाइव हूँ। थैंक यू फॉर वेलकमिंग मी इन एट योर होम। आई अप्रिशिएट योर वेलकम। सो मैं पहुंच चुका हूँ आपके घरों में, और आज मैं बात करूंगा आपसे, दो मौलिक रचनाएं मैं आपके साथ शेयर करूंगा, मेरी अपनी ओरिजिनल कंपाइलेशंस हैं। उसमें से पहली जो रचना है मेरी काफी पुरानी है, जो जब मैं ऑफिस जाया करता था, अभी तो यही बोल सकते हैं जाया करता था, 5-6 महीने हो गए ऑफिस जाते हुए, घर से काम कर रहे हैं, बहुत अच्छा समय व्यतीत हो रहा है। तो उन दिनों जब ट्रैफिक में गुजरते थे, उन दिनों बीच में कुछ एक विचार आया जो मैंने एक लिख डाला, और ये पहली कविता मेरी उसके ऊपर आधारित है। और दूसरी वाली कविता जो जिस दौर से हम आजकल गुजर रहे हैं, महामारी के दौर से, उसके ऊपर एक मैंने छोटी सी कविता लिखी हुई है। दोनों कविताएं मैं एक के बाद एक आपके साथ शेयर करूंगा। दोनों कविताओं में एक बहुत ही सुंदर सा मैसेज भी है जो कि आखिर में रहेगा। तो मैं शुरू करता हूँ। मेरी पहली कविता है, कविता का शीर्षक है आइडल, मेरे पिता मेरे आइडल। तो कविता इस प्रकार है दोस्तों। पिछले दिनों कारण बना प्राइमरी स्कूल जाने का, मैंने सोचा मौका बहुत अच्छा है बच्चों से बतियाने का। एक बच्चे को जब पूछा आपका कौन है आपका आइडल, उसने जवाब दिया मेरे पिताजी बिना गंवाए एक भी पल। अचरज हुआ जानकर आज की एज में बच्चे का आइडल पिता, आजकल तो बच्चों को भाता है डोरेमान और नोबिता। पैरों तले जमीन न रही जब असली कारण जाना, बच्चे ने बोला पिताजी की तरह पूरी तरह बनूंगा और दिमाग में था ठान, उन्हीं की तरह गाड़ी चलाऊंगा। ध्यान दीजिएगा बच्चे के विचार, उन्हीं की तरह गाड़ी चलाऊंगा, ना हेलमेट पहनूंगा ना सीट बेल्ट लगाऊंगा, सिग्नल जंप करूंगा, मोबाइल भी चलाऊंगा, और पुलिस वाला दिखेगा तो झट से अच्छा बन जाऊंगा। मैंने बात को कंटिन्यू किया और उससे आगे पूछा क्या करोगे जब पुलिस वाला पकड़ लेगा, क्या करोगे जब पुलिस वाला पकड़ लेगा, चालान कटेगा और पर्ची हाथ में देगा। बच्चा बहुत ही हाजे जवाबी था। कोई बात नहीं, बोला आसानी से बच जाऊंगा, पिता दादा का नाम लेकर धमकाते हैं, मैं पिता के नाम से धमकाऊंगा। अक्सर हम ऐसे ही बिहेव करते हैं जब कोई ऐसा काम दौरान ऐसे कुछ होता है, वी यूजुअली से यू डोंट नो हु एम आई, आप जानते नहीं मेरे पिताजी कौन है, फला फला। सो पिताजी दादा का नाम लेके धमकाते हैं, मैं पिताजी के नाम से धमकाऊंगा, ज्यादा कुछ हुआ तो ले दे के निपटा लूंगा, कुछ भी करूंगा पर चालान नहीं भरूंगा। दिमाग बंद हो गया और मैं सन्न रह गया, एक ही सांस में ये बच्चा क्या कह गया। दिमाग बंद हो गया और मैं संग रह गया, एक ही बात बात में बच्चा ये क्या कह गया। सच है दोस्तों, हम आज नियमों को नहीं मानते हैं। सच है दोस्तों, हम आज नियमों को नहीं मानते हैं, पर ये महामारी कब थमेगी क्या हम जानते हैं। हमारे बच्चे हमें अपना आइडल समझते हैं, हमारे बच्चे हमें अपना आइडल समझते हैं। जरा विचार करो, क्या हम उनके आगे ठीक उदाहरण पेश करते हैं। तो ये थी मेरी पहली रचना। और दूसरी रचना, मैं थोड़ी सी तैयारी कर लूं। दूसरी रचना मेरी, एज मैंने जैसे कि बोला, अभी एक हमारे जिस दौर से हम गुजर रहे हैं अभी पेंडेमिक से, महामारी के दौरान, उसके बारे में है। जो लोग मुझे यूट्यूब पर फॉलो करते हैं डेफिनेटली इन्होंने ये सुनी होगी। कविता का शीर्षक है भूल जाएंगे हम। तो पेश है कविता भूल जाएंगे हम। भूल जाएंगे हम दोस्तियां दोस्तों सॉरी भूल जाएंगे हम पार्टियां दोस्तों यारों की, भूल जाएंगे हम पार्टियां दोस्तों यारों की और शादी में भीड़ सैकड़ों हजारों की। भूल जाएंगे हम जाकर लाना सामान दुकान से और भूल जाएंगे हम बीच रहा बतियाना किसी अनजान से। भूल जाएंगे हम सुंदर शक्लों पर मुस्कान और पेड़ के नीचे नाई की दुकान। भूल जाएंगे हम कहना थैंक गॉड आज फ्राइडे है, भूल जाएंगे हम कहना थैंक गॉड आज फ्राइडे है और दारू की दुकान के बाहर बोर्ड आज ड्राइडे है। साथ ही साथ हम भूल जाएंगे हम भरी मेट्रो में ऑफिस जाना और शादी में किसी दूसरे की प्लेट से खाना। ये सब हम भूल जाएंगे, लेकिन याद रहेगा तो याद क्या रहेगा, याद रहेगा तो बस लॉकडाउन में बिताए खट्टे मीठे परिवार के साथ खट्टे मीठे पल। याद रहेगा तो बस परिवार के लॉकडाउन में परिवार के साथ बिताए खट्टे मीठे पल। इंतजार उस सूचना का, क्या लॉकडाउन खुलेगा कल। याद रहेगा वो दोस्तों रिश्तेदारों के संदेशों में ढेर सारा प्यार, वो दोस्तों रिश्तेदारों के संदेशों में ढेर सारा प्यार और डॉक्टर पुलिस और सफाई कर्मचारियों का हम सब पर उपकार, वो हम कभी नहीं भूल पाएंगे। सच है दोस्तों, ये कोरोना हमें बहुत कुछ सिखा गया। सच है दोस्तों, ये कोरोना हमें बहुत कुछ सिखा गया। बाकी कुछ हो ना हो, शांति संतोष और सहायता का पाठ पढ़ा गया। तो ये थी मेरी दो मौलिक रचनाएं। आखिर में एक छोटा सा किसी अनजान शेर का मैं शायर का एक शेर पेश करता हूं और उससे मैं कंक्लूड करता हूं कि सितारों को आंखों में महफूज रखना, जो आप आज हम यादें बुन रहे हैं चुन रहे हैं, उनके सितारे हमारी आंखों में चमकेंगे ता जिंदगी। तो सितारों को आंखों में महफूज रखना, अभी दूर तक रात ही रात होगी, मुसाफिर हो तुम भी और मुसाफिर हूं मैं भी, कभी किसी मोड़ पर यूं मुलाकात होगी। इसी के साथ दोस्तों अलविदा, स्टे सेफ स्टे एट होम, सुरक्षित रहें घर पर रहें, थैंक यू।
विनीत सर छा गए सर, आपने तो छा दिया। एवरीबॉडी कैन वी हैव अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर हिम प्लीज, कैन यू प्लीज अनम्यूट योर माइक एंड गिव हिम अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज। एकदम छा गए सर, दिल को छू लिया आपने आपकी बातें। ऑलराइट सर, ये कहना चाहूंगा, अभिजीत सिंह यहाँ पर कह रहे हैं कि वी हैव अ रामधारी सिंह दिनकर इन द हाउस, क्या विचार है सर? रामधारी सिंह दिनकर इन द हाउस, ये हमारे खुद के एचपीई सीएससी बैंगलोर के रामधारी सिंह दिनकर हैं। लेकिन विनीत सर आपसे पूछना चाहूंगा, जैसे कि मैंने अलीशा से पूछा कि हर शायर का एक अतीत होता है, हर शायर का एक खोया हुआ प्यार होता है, तभी वो शायर बनता है, तभी उनकी आवाज में दर्द आती है, उनके लफ्ज में दर्द आती है। आपका क्या है सर अतीत, बताइए थोड़ा।
राकेश भाई मैं शादीशुदा हूँ।
वही अतीत है। That itself says it all. You're married and you're going through one of the biggest tortures of your life, and that's why it's made you what you are today. Is it? Are you trying to say that, Vinit sir?
No, nothing like that. Just to keep it on lighter note. But okay. I'm enjoying my life.
Thank you, sir. Fantastic. Very few married men who say that, but I know we very well know that Vinit right now is lying. But it's okay. We'll take that with a pinch of salt. Thank you, Vinit sir. Thank you so much. It was lovely performance from you. All right, guys. I'm going to now move into another performance, after which I come back to a little interaction with you all. Here it is. on our HPCSC Bangalore, there's no place like working from home. This first day of a week-long activity that we've lined up for you. We're doing an open mic house right here in the afternoon. And the next performer that I'm going to bring onto your screens is going to be a recorded performance, a dance performance by none other than Ashwini Yu. Please unmute your mics and give them a round of applause. Please give Ashwini a round of applause. Come on. Unmute and clap. We would like to hear your sound. Over to Ashwini. Wow. Ashwini, can we have a round of applause for Ashwini? Please unmute your mics and give her a big round of applause, guys. Come on, Abhijit Singh, Rijesh, I'm waiting for your applauses. Get your cameras on, guys. You guys are constantly switching your cameras off. Get your cameras on. Go for it. Okay, coming to Ashwini. Can we have you on the screen, please? Are you there?
Yes, Rakesh. Can you hear me?
I have a very simple question to ask you. That first dance that you did with the lungi and the jacket and all of that on your terrace, what did you consume before doing that dance?
To be very honest, I wanted to do something more, and okay. I practiced, and I somehow feel the output is not what exactly I want. I wanted to do more, but I'm so glad I was able to showcase what I did during the lockdown to all of you today.
You still didn't answer my question. I asked you, what did you consume before you started that first
performance? I think chai.
Chai. You're sure it's just chai?
Yes, it is just chai.
Ashwini, I think you also gave a lot of free show to your neighbors, because your neighbors would have had a good time watching you perform on the terrace, right?
Very true. So now these days when I go upstairs, they ask me, is this for a dance performance? So that question is there every now and then these days, yeah.
All right, lovely, Ashwini. Thank you so much for that piece of dance that you gave us. It was absolutely lovely. We loved every bit of what you did. Thank you so much. All right, ladies and gentlemen, moving on to my next performer. We've done a lot of dancing. We've done a lot of cocaine poetry and all of it, but we haven't heard anyone sing so far, right? I'm going to be bringing out the super singer who's there at HPECSC Bangalore. She's going to be doing a recorded performance for us again. Please put your hands together. Unmute your mics, everyone. Put your hands together for Akshita Gandotra. Come on, everyone. Akshita Gandotra was giving us a singing performance right here live onto the screen. God, why did that just stop? I wanted you to just keep going. Can I have you on the screen, please? Can I have you on the screen, Akshita Gandotra? My God, are you here? Are you here with us? Akshita, are you here with us? Akshita Gandotra? My God, what a lovely performance. Can we have a round of applause for her, please? Unmute your mics and give her a big round of applause. She certainly deserves this. She deserves this. Are you there with us, Akshita? I don't think she's here. Is she here? If she's here, can you please come onto the screen with us? Okay. Akshita. No, that's Deekshit. I want Akshita. Okay, but nevertheless, I think absolutely, absolutely beautiful. So mellifluous with her voice. And great show. Thank you so much, Akshita. If you were here, we would have loved to read out these messages for you. Upasana says, there's always that kanak in your voice. Great one again. Saad Mohammed says, lovely talent. Sindhu says, true, want to hear more. Of course, Har Kamal Kaur says superb. Guys, whatever you feel about these performances, obviously we can't talk to everyone right now. We can't actually have everyone respond at the same time. So just go to your chats and send out those messages. It's just like your way of giving it back to these people who are giving you so much on the screens, all right? So just make sure you go to your chats and write whatever you want to. It could just be a word. It's just your appreciation will make a lot, a great deal to them, yeah? Very beautiful voice, says Vineet Bharadwaj. Thank you so much. Not mine. Akshita's, right? I'm sure you're talking about her. All right. Quickly, let's move on. Before we move on, I have another question for you that I want to use out here. Okay. I want to know from this audience. It is said scientifically, women are better at remembering things than men. Okay. Scientifically, it is proved that women are better at remembering things than men. Is this true or false? I want you to tell me if it is true or false, and why do you think it's true or false? After which we move into the last and the final set of performances we've got. So come in, quickly go to your chat and send it to everyone. Scientifically, it's proven that women are better at remembering things than men. True or false? Quick. And I want to read out the responses as well. I want everyone to respond to this. Everyone, please go to your chat. Whatever that you may have to say, it could be something serious, silly, stupid, emotional, whatever, but I want an answer. Okay. Niharika says true because we have more feelings in every moment. Niharika, I'm a little offended with that answer. Can you please come onto the screen and tell me? Unmute your mic and talk to me, Niharika. You're saying that yes, women remember more things than men because we have more feelings for every moment than men.
Niharika. Yeah. Hi, Rakesh.
Yes, Niharika, please. Unmute. Can you switch on your camera, please, Niharika?
My camera has some problem. I'm sorry.
Okay. Please go ahead. It's not just the camera that has some problem right now. I'll tell you what else has a problem with you. With the way you've written that answer, I think there's something more that has a problem with you. What is this? Women have more feelings for a moment than we men? Did you just say that?
Yes. I'm now married for last 9 years, and I believe that because in every moment we live, we put more emotions and more feelings. That's why we remember everything. We can relate to that feeling, and we memorize each date and each day that we lived. Yeah, that's my thought.
You know what, Niharika? I can only tell you about myself, okay? I had been in the Big Boss house for 95 days. The amount of emotions that poured out of me on national television, I was seen crying. I was seen fighting. I was seen whining. I was seen like literally in pain. If those are not emotions, you can't just take this away. Okay.
No, that's only because you were put into in some house locked, right? You were not able to go out or do something, right? We women actually, we no matter what, we are outside the world. We go to offices, we come back home, whatever it may be. But we have, like, I believe that we express more, we have more emotions attached to anything we do. It be it work, be it our house. Anything.
Fine. Meri Ma, Bharat Mata ki jai. I'm not going to fight with you further. Okay, there is someone who's given a very deep, insightful thought. Pradhan Bopanna says, yes, it is true that scientifically women remember more than men. It's because my wife remembers all the mistakes I make. Wow, Pradhan Bopanna, can you please come onto the screen? I want to talk to you. Pradhan, kya ho raha hai tumhare saath ghar par, Pradhan? Come on, talk to me, Pradhan. You're saying your wife remembers all the mistakes you make. Why do you make so many mistakes then that you let her remember all this? Pradhan, please unmute and talk to me right now. Quick. Okay, Pradhan isn't here. I'm going to go to Tabitha, who says, who needs science when there's a practical proof? Women mostly ask, you don't remember? Totally. Tabitha, please come to me right now. Tabitha, unmute yourself and come to me right now.
You also had a lot of women tell you don't remember? I've never had any guy ask me, you don't remember? It's either women or probably to be truthful, also ask, you don't remember?
I'll tell you why men don't want to ask that, do you remember? Because you know, the moment you ask, you could just start off.
Yes.
Right? They will not have a
point. That will open the Pandora's box. There is no time limit.
There is no time limit. All right. Guys, you know what? I'm going to take one last response and then I'm going to go into my final set of performances that we've lined up. I have someone who says, Upasana says, yes, but sometimes they pretend to forget to keep up men's spirit. Upasana? can you please unmute and talk to me right now? Upasana, you're saying that sometimes you'll pretend that you forget only to match up with our spirits so that we don't feel bad. Did you just say that?
No, I just said that men try to pretend that they have forgotten, but they don't, because they have this notion, kyun mard ko dard nahi hota, and if they start remembering, other men also have to start remembering things. So, wo ye bhai chara unka khatam na ho jaye iska.
My God, at what intense, deep level are you been researching about men's minds? I couldn't have even thought of something like that. Oh my God, thank you so much. Okay, and I hear someone else also who says, Ravi Ranjan says, wife remembers your mistakes and husband remembers all the good things about wife. Ravi Ranjan, kitni pyari si life hai aapki. Please come onto the screen and talk to me. So you remember all the good things about your wife and your wife remembers all the bad things about you? Is that what you're trying to say? That's your marriage? That's a description of your marriage? Ravi Ranjan.
Yeah, that is true. So I'm married for last 10 years. Mm-hmm. Remembers all the things where I did mistake, and
yeah, I can see that you're married for the last 10 years. I can see the proof standing right next to you. But tell me something, after 10 years, you still want to say that your wife is the one who picks on your mistakes and you never do?
No, not only mistakes, but she remembers everything.
Everything. She'll remember what you did on the 21st of December, 1965, and she'll bring it up at the wrong time in the argument for you to defend it. Right?
Yeah. And I tend to remember only good things that happened to us.
You know what? I don't want to appreciate you or cheer for you for the kind of answer you've given, but I want to really sympathize with you because we really know what's happening with you back at home. So all the very best dealing with that. Okay. I'm quickly going to move into the performances right now. Thank you so much for all your lovely responses. I wish I could read out more, but we are running short of time. I'm going to go into our last three performances that are lined up right now, reciting a speech with a video collage. In a very beautifully recorded video. Here we have Supriya Bhatt, who's taking us through it. Unmute your mics and please give her a round of applause and stay on the cameras, please. Last few performances, unmute your mic and give her a round of applause. Supriya Bhatt, over to you. Recorded video, you're on your consoles.
Hi. She can't be on call right now because her
travel involved. You can wake up 10 minutes before office hours, have breakfast leisurely because there's no cab waiting, and walk around in your pajamas. Coronavirus is upon us and the lockdown was inevitable. It's like the time when the teacher said in school, you had to read something for homework. It meant there was no homework, or that's what I thought. Week one at home was more or less perfect. I converted the dining table to my desk, headphones plugged in. Mummy's coffee was better than the office machine espresso. And who needed the chair when you had the whole bed to yourself? It was all going great, hot lunches and naps. The past 3 weeks, I have been changing my chair at home every day. Just after the 7th day of working from home, my excitement had died down. It's a lot like the school kids who thought this was a perfect vacation, only to find out that the society had shut down the play area. And now I'm just a grumpy girl, staring at my laptop, irritated by the erratic internet. I have run out of small talks to make with my father. I never thought I'd say this, but I think I'm beginning to miss my office family a little. If friends are the family you choose, then your co-workers are the family you are contractually obligated to be with for at least 9 hours every day. We spend more time with them than Sambit Patra does at Republic TV Studios. From sutta breaks to heartbreaks, there's no escaping from your office fam. The age of swipes, for many of us, it's the only steady relationship we have had. And if you have been working at one place for longer than 2 years, they know you and your mood swings better than anyone else. They say you don't have friends at work, but no one ever told me that you might find a work spouse. We aren't like Jim and Pam from the office. In the sense, there's no romance brewing, but he can tell from my expression whether I just got a scolding from my boss or an appraisal worth celebrating by ordering a pizza or maybe a samosa. The office just becomes your comfort space without you even realizing it. The past 3 weeks, I've been changing my chair at home every day. I've gone from the bedroom to the balcony, from the sofa to the rocking chair, but somehow I still can't find my spot. My slightly wobbly chair is a part of my arsenal and I feel unharmed without it. These last few days of social distancing have got me thinking. I always thought my office was too loud. By the way, it was me who used to make noise most of the time in my team. But now I'm craving for all those chaos. To watch someone panicking after dropping dal on his white shirt and worrying about how this will trigger a world war at home. Or accidentally getting a Rona or having a P1 or maybe an escalation. I can't channel my inner gym helper and play practical pranks like sending a party invite from the new joinee from their laptop because they forgot it to log before stepping out. And by the way, this was done to me and I'm still not sure who did it. See, that kind of humor isn't appreciated at home, where you could lose your name from the family will if you turn off the Wi-Fi when your dad is on WhatsApp or he's watching news on his Jio TV. That's the thing about colleagues. They get used to your sense of humor. They don't ask too many questions when you are usually quiet. It's like a no-effort relationship, and you probably never realize how close you are until your pesky colleagues are not around or until the boss tells you that you have.
Wow. I mean, wow, Supriya. You know what you've just done? You've got a lot of people nostalgic about the office. We have Rajesh Yajaman who says the images of the office are very nostalgic now. Sriraj says, missing office. Saad Mohammed says, jaane kahan gaye wo din. Wow. You know what? I must just tell you, I love certain parts of your speech where you put down that how when we are contractually bound to be with a set of people for a set number of hours every day, and we always probably didn't quite like that because we wanted to get away from it. Today, how that contractual bound has kind of made you look upon them like family. Right? We all do certainly miss our office and workspaces. Like they say, right? You only need the light when it's burning low and only when you miss the sun when it starts to snow. That's exactly what's happened. And it's only at least made us realize how important and how much we value these ties, these relationships or these bonds that we build at workplaces. Lovely. Can we have you on the screen? I would want to give you a good round of applause. Can you everybody unmute your mics and give Supriya a big round of applause, please? Come on. Supriya Bhatt on the screen, if you can come and if you're here, please. And I can see a lot of messages that have... Yes, Supriya.
No, it's not Supriya. She can't come because she's in Jammu currently and there the internet is on only 2G speed. So she can't...
Okay, okay. But nevertheless, this entire event is recorded. I'm sure she can watch this. Kavyashree also says, oh man, miss all those beautiful days. Prank emails of 1 crore in bank account to party for the whole team. Quick short tea breaks, the gym sessions. Siddharth says, so touchy. Never knew I would miss office and my colleagues so much. Of course, like I said, it's only when the light is burning low, you start missing it, right? You want more of it when it's burning low. Fantastic. I'm going to move into my next two last performances that I've lined up for you. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we'll get into a little more singing. It's going to be Venkat Acharya, who's going to do a live performance for us right here on the screens. And I want you to unmute your mics and give him a live applause right now. Come on. Venkat Acharya, over to you.
Hi, Rakesh.
Hello.
I'm Venkat Atreya. So
Atreya, okay, I'm sorry.
Confusion maybe.
Sorry, it's given as Acharya here. So Venkat Acharya, go ahead.
Yes. So I'll be performing a very beautiful song from Kannada movie called Jashmat Matali, which was sung beautifully by Raghu Dixit sir and composed by him. And it's done beautiful hit.
I know this song, yes. Of course it's
Can you guys guess the song first?
I know it.
Yeah, you can say it aloud.
It's a title track of Jashmat Matali, right?
Yeah, I mean, it has Jashmat Matali, but it's Munjane Manjali. Yes.
Munjane Manjali, yes, of course. I sang this entire song. I was actually forced to learn this entire song in the Big Boss house.
And I know, Rakesh, that's why it's for you.
Thank you so much, buddy. Go ahead. Go ahead. I love the song.
Is it audible?
Yes, perfectly. Go ahead.
जाने मंजली मुसंजे तिड़ी तंपली वो अलवे नीनली हुड़काटा नीन गिन्नली नन्नरे उड़गे नीनिले दो जड़ामर दामों ना मुरी दो विश्वसिरनु नी बगे दो ನಿಟ್ಟುಸಿರನ್ನು ನೀ ತೆಗೆದು ನನ್ನು ಆವರಿಸು ಈ ಬೆಳೆ ನೀ ಹರಿಸು ಮನದಾಳದ ಉಲ್ಲಾಸ ಕುಂದಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ಮುಂದಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ಸರಿ ನನ್ನಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ಕನಸಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ಸರಿ ನನನೆನ್ನೆಗಳು ನೀನೆ ನಾಳೆಗಳು ನೀನೆ ಎಂದೆಂದು ನೀನೆ ಸಹಿ ಆವರಿಸು ಮೈದುಂಬಿ ಸ್ಮಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾತಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನಲ್ಲ ಕನಸನ್ನು ನಿನ್ನದೆಂದು ನೀ ತಿಳಿದಿದ್ದೆ ನೂರೆಂಟು ನೋವನ್ನು ನೀ ಬಂದು ಜೊತೆ ಇದ್ದೆ ಕಾರ್ಮೋಡ ಕವಿದ ಮನಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊಸ ಬೆಳಕು ತಂದು ಸುರಿದೆ ನಿನಗಾಗಿ ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಬದುಕೆಲ್ಲ ಮುಗಿದು ಎಂದೇ ಹೀಗಲ್ಲಿ ನೀ ಹೋದೆ ಕನಿಕರಿಸಿ ನೀ ಬಾರೆ ಎದೆಗೂಡಿ ನಾ ಉಸಿರು ನೀನೇ ಬಾನಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ಭೂಮಿಯಲ್ಲೂ ನೀನೆ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೂ ನೀನೆ ಸಖಿ ಬಲ್ಲಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ನಡುವಲ್ಲು ನೀನೆ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೂ ನೀನೆ ಸಖಿ ನನನೆನ್ನೆಗಳು ನೀನೆ ನಾಳೆಗಳು ನೀನೆ ಎಂದೆಂದು ನೀನೆ ಸಖಿ ಆವರಿಸು
ಜಯ ಲಾಕ್
ಮೈದುಂಬಿ ಮಾತಲ್ಲಿ
send in your responses on the chat. Continue, Venkat, continue.
This is one of the most amazing songs. Every time I sing this, goosebumps.
Same here.
ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೂ ನೀನೆ ಸಖಿ ಹಸಿರಲು ನೀನೆ ಉಸಿರಲು ನೀನೆ ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೂ ನೀನೆ ಸಖಿ ನನನೆನ್ನೆಗಳು ನೀನೆ ನಾಳೆಗಳು ನೀನೆ ಎಂದೆಂದು ನೀನೆ ಸಖಿ ಆವರಿಸು
That's it. Thank you.
Wow. You know what, Venkat, nimge hege gotarano harshisudu. You know how I actually want to cheer for you. I would say Venkat Ramana, Govinda, Govinda. Fantastic performance. Our performance in the Nijwagla Hiltini. It took me back to my Big Boss days. It just kind of got me a little nostalgic. I see a lot of responses that have come in on the other side.
I must read that.
Komala Chetan, who says that it's one of my favorite songs. Very nice, Venkat. Arun David says, awesome, Maga. And Saad Mohammed says, Adbhuta Vagittu. And Monica says, awesome. Upasana says, such an energetic live performance. Sikkapatte worldly responses galu bandide. Thank you so much for bringing back those memories and giving us such a beautiful performance, Venkat. Nodidre nivu ond element alli idri idi performance alli yaradru yochane maartta idri yaradru bagge. Were you thinking of somebody while you were singing?
Illa yaarnu yochane maartilla. Just I just feel the song every time I sing this, and every time I perform anywhere I feel the song. And then I don't know if you remember me. We have performed. I've shared the same stage with you in one of the corporate events across.
Oh wow! Okay, DJ Sharad. I must have. Yes, I must have. Venkat, he's hardly held that. Then yendendu nine sakhi anta yarappa nin sakhi held, but it's okay. Paragla.
Like one random dialogue debe kundre area gollo dirtare yaro ante helado.
For those of you who didn't get it in Kannada, let me translate it for you. The song talks about how you are my eternal friend and how you're just going to be my partner for life is what the song talks about. And I just asked him, who do you think your partner is? He says, every area has one partner. What can I talk about? Just keep sending in your chats, just send in your responses, just share with us how you're feeling, what you like about it, what you don't like about it. Just send in on your chats so that we just know what to do, what you're feeling like. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to move into my next performance. This is again going to be a singing performance, but it's going to be with a live instrument. Yeah, something really to watch out for, ladies and gentlemen. With a round of applause, I'm going to welcome Saloni onto the screen only after you unmute your mics and you applaud for her. Come on, everyone, unmute your mics and applaud for Saloni, who's going to be taking on the last performance on our open mic. After which, I have a little surprise for you guys, so hang in there.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Saloni. Saloni Kumari, go ahead. What instrument are you going to play for us? You have a harmonium?
Instrument over here. Yes, I have a harmonium over here.
Wow, I love the old school. I love the old school, purest form of music.
So, first of all, I'll be starting with a pure sargam, which I love to play on a harmonium. So,
Go ahead, we're waiting for you. Lovely, Saloni. Very, very beautiful. Give her a round of applause, everyone. Can you please unmute your mics and give her a round of applause, everyone?
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Lovely. Go ahead. What do we have next?
So now I'm gonna go forward with our diversity. As we see in our India, we have so many languages. So I just want to start with Goa's language, Goa's local language, which is known as Konkani Goa, right?
Yes.
So, I have a song. I hope you guys will be able to just guess it, and I'm gonna sing it, and I'll be then breaking the code also with the Hindi version of it. So I hope you guys will break the code.
Go for it, Saloni. Yes.
हम साई बापुर तोड़ी वही ताम दा मोइला लोक ना का वही ताम बक साई बाबा आटे दा कोई बक साई बाबा आटे कोलो ना हम साई बापुर तोड़ी वही ताम दा मोइला लोक ना का वही ताम बक साई बाबा आटे दा कोई बक साई बाबा आटे कोलो ना मांगो सोना चांदी ना मांगो हीरा मोती ये मेरे किस काम के देती है दिल दे बदले में दिल के दे 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 सेवा प्यार में सौदा नहीं. Thank you.
Lovely. Give her a round of applause, please. Wherever you are, virtually, let's hear it for her. Lovely, Saloni. Lovely, lovely.
So, next, I have actually, I'm sorry if I pronounce it wrong. I know we have so many friends, Tamilian friends we have with us, but I just want to sing a Tamil song here. So, Chinna chinna se, sirgadi kumase, muttu muttu ase, mudivintav ase, vennilav tattu. मस्ती भरे मन की भोली सी आशा चांद तारों को छूने की आशा आसमानों में उड़ने की आशा दिल है छोटा सा छोटी सी आशा.
Lovely, awesome performance that was. Lovely, Saloni Kumari. Do we have more or are we done?
Just one more song I have. I want to sing. No, it's a song from Half Girlfriend movie. So din charkhe ki ek doori sufi uska rang hai usne jo tera khwab piroya neende bani patang dil bharta nahi aankhein rachte nahi dil bharta nahi aankhein rachte nahi chahe kitna bhi dekhte jaun वक्त जाए मैं रोक न पाऊं तू थोड़ी देर और ठहर जा सोनिया तू थोड़ी देर और ठहर जा तू थोड़ी देर और ठहर जा जालिमा तू थोड़ी देर और ठहर जा. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
Wow. Can everybody please unmute your mics and give her a round of applause? Very well deserved that applause for you. Please, go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And you know what? I was a little surprised. I was a little surprised the way you sang Tamil. I was a little worried. You know, I'm like, she doesn't know the language and how would she even manage? But I think you did a fantastic job. I think you did a fantastic job.
Love learning new languages, be it programming language or be it language.
Okay, so, considering that you're in Bangalore, do you know any bit of Kannada? Do you know any bit of Kannada?
No, Kannada Gotilla. This is what I know.
Hold on, I'm going to teach you something right now, okay? whenever you look at your boss, it's a nice greeting that I'm going to teach you.
Okay.
Just say, ho go lay. Say it.
I want to confirm it if that is a meeting only because I doubt you.
No. Just say ho go lay. Ho go lay. Just say it. Ho go lay.
Ho go lay?
Yeah, ho go lay.
Okay, ho go lay.
Yeah, say this to your boss every time you meet him, okay? The morning meetings.
I'm afraid I'll have to search the meaning of it
I'll let you guessing that. I'll let you keep guessing on that. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to an end of the session. I want everyone to stay for another 2 minutes and I'm going to let you go after this. That brings us to an end of our session 2 of day 1. Okay. But there is one more that's going to be happening this evening. Firstly, I want everyone to unmute your mics and give all the performers who came on board today to entertain us a big, big round of applause, please. Come on, everyone, give them a big, big round of applause. I think they deserve it all for entertaining us. All of them who came in onto the screen from Alicia, starting with Alicia, Harkaval, Jonathan, Shreya, Vineet, Ashwini, Akshita, Supriya, Venkat, Saloni. Whatever you want to say about any of these, go to your chat and leave your messages about them. Leave your thoughts for them, and that'll be really lovely because they would love to read it. Right now, before I sign off and tell you what you're going to be coming back for in the night, I have a little thing because a couple of requests have come to me privately asking me if I could perform a live Professor Ulfat Sultan. Okay, for those of you who are not from Bangalore, let me tell you, a Professor Ulfat Sultan is a radio humor character. It used to come on the radio and teach 2 English words in his Urdu. And while he used to do that, his life and wife used to come into the picture and everything used to go for a toss. That Professor Ulfat Sultan radio character is something that I've been writing and voicing. I don't claim this. The industry says that after 10 years and 278 scripts or so, today, Professor Ulfat Sultan happens to be the longest standing humor character on Indian radio. So since the requests have come in, I'm going to give you one live Sultan. Do you want it? If you want it, please show a thumbs up on your screens and I can see you guys. Yeah. If you want it, here goes. All right. Sultan School of Speech. Salaam alaikum sabhi ko. My Professor Ulfat Sultan. Seekho mere saath English ki do baat. Today's 2 English word are jelly and belly. Jelly ko to wo color ke rubber mafik transparent mitais aati dekho. Which belly ko to tumhare stomachs ke upar wo sponge mafik portion par dondi hain dekho. Which now put it one sentence. When Shakira shakes her belly, it moves like jelly. But jab mere mohalle ki lady pailwan Miss Hafsa Begum shakes her belly, full tremors in my gully. Sometimes it reaches from Marathali to Bomanali. That is Professor Ulfat Sultan for you. Thank you so much for all your love. I still do continue this character live on my social media. On Instagram, it is as mjrakesh.blr. MJ stands for Mike Jockey. So it's mjrakesh.blr on Instagram. And on Facebook, it's called mjrakesh.sultan. I would love to see you guys there showing love to this character. But right now, there is Professor Ulfat Sultan version 2.0, which is called Pathez, which is already launched on Red FM. You can watch it there. Thank you so much. On that note, let me tell you what you guys are going to come back for at 8 p.m. tonight. You're going to catch the leadership talk and a game of bingo with another MC who's going to be on board, an artist, a good friend, Riaz Basha. Tomorrow at 10 a.m., you're going to catch him again with a leadership talk again and a bingo game and a game of bingo. And tomorrow, 3 p.m., I'm going to be back with a session of what I call Poll Code. It's a specially curated, handcrafted segment, which I've made just for HPE CSC Bangalore, which I'm going to be tomorrow, 3 p.m. And yes, day after, you're going to be catching the also enigmatic Ada Sharma, who's going to be in the morning at 10 a.m., bringing you a session of yoga and meditation. So there's a lot that's lined up for you right throughout this week. Make sure you log in on time because we are starting on time. If you're missing the bus, you're missing a lot. On that note, this is me, MJ Rakesh, aka Professor Ulfat Sultan, your mic jockey, Big Boss Rocky, saying a tata, bye-bye. We'll see you at 8 p.m. along with Riaz Basha. Thank you so much, guys. Bye-bye.